The first step was not to step on the wire and trip myself and make a fool, but okay. And we also say, if it ain't raining, we ain't training. So I'm kind of used to this, and it is a beautiful, beautiful day to be here. On behalf of my colleagues, the other four commissioners, and I, really just truly support all of these efforts. I've often said that no one knows Carroll County better than Carroll Countyans, and we just do it right. We have a veterans program and an approach that ain't about flagpoles and monuments. It's about calls to action, whether transportation or veteran support officers. And this is just another call to action. Having a park, having a place of solitude, having the benches, having a place to reflect is so important for our veterans and their families. I spent 30 plus years in uniform, and it's not just about me. It's about my family, my wife. Thank goodness I married 27 levels up, and my children who have dealt with multiple deployments and have stuck with me all along. It's not about the deployments. It's about the opportunity to raise your hand willfully. Every veteran in here has done that. They've raised their hand and given up inalienable rights that they had to ensure that we all have our inalienable rights. Let that sit in. I raised that hand, giving up certain inalienable rights to ensure we all have our inalienable rights. So therefore, when someone says thank you for the service that I provide, I say thank you for giving me a reason to serve. That's what this is all about. I want to share a reflection I have, and it was a story told by the late Secretary George Owings, who became a great leader, mentor, and close friend, who passed this past year. It was at, I think, Garrison Cemetery, and there was a gentleman sitting on a bench, an older gentleman. And Secretary Owings went over to the gentleman and sat down beside him. He didn't know who Secretary Owings was, and if you don't know Secretary Owings, you wouldn't know who he is, except a really cool old guy who just is very happy. I mean, he always smiled. And he started talking to this gentleman and said, are you a veteran? Yes, I am. I served in Vietnam. And Secretary Owens said, so did I. He said, by chance, do you have one of these VA cards? And he goes, no, I just served, 18 months. I was drafted. I came back. I'm done. He goes, well, let me walk you through the process. And he's like, well, okay, you're kind of a nice old man, but what do you know about, the VA? So he kind of explained to him who he was in his own humble self, and he walked this gentleman through the veteran services process. This gentleman received a couple $100,000 on the spot when he was recognized for all of the challenges that he had built up while he was a veteran, serving, and then after his service. So the challenge to you is, if you know a veteran, ask them, do they have that card? Ask them if they've gone through the process. As you see someone sitting on the bench reflecting, ask them. It may be a child, it may be a wife or a spouse, a husband or wife, and ask them. Because it's not just for me, it's for my family. That's the call of action that we need to embrace. I don't want me to be on a pulpit saying all of this, but there's 10,000 plus veterans in Carroll County. We do such a great job, but for every veteran that's out there that has one of these cards, I guarantee you there's two or three that don't. It's okay to say, how are you doing? And ask them the question. And if they do, that's great. And then say, tell two friends to tell two friends. We've recognized a lot of our leaders, and I know State's Attorney Haven Shoemaker, who's a friend of the community, is somewhere. There you are. Thank you also for being here. The thunder was taken away from me when I was going to recognize all our veterans, but that's okay. That's okay. They know who they are. We know who they are. But there are a lot of leaders out here from the nonprofits, from the Americans Legions, and from all the different organizations, the Catholic War Veterans. And really thank you for giving your selfless service and continued service May get a pay raise next time you see, you know, I see you, which is nothing to nothing. But I really do appreciate all the work that you do. This is a great day. And honestly, and I can share this with you honestly, because I'm pretty transparent. When I spoke to our administrator, Roberta, and Deb yesterday, I was not expecting such a crowd to be here this morning. And this is just wonderful. It's another testament of how cool we are here in Carroll County. The last thing I want to leave you with is, this is what needs to be above the fold on the front page of every newspaper. The commitment that the community has to our veterans, the commitment that the community has to our community. So if the Times or anyone else is listening, that's what I would like to see on the top of the fold, is why we're here. To honor those that raised their right hand, to honor those that have raised their right hand, their families, their spouses, and their children who have endured, whether it be a one-year deployment or 30-plus years, whatever it may be. You raised that right hand for all the right reasons. So thank you for giving me a reason to serve. And with that, I hand it back over to somebody. Oh, cool. Now, this is dangerous. Giving me sharp instruments is a very dangerous thing. But let me have the commissioners up here, the delegate, state's attorney, and all the others that have been a part of this. Lisa, where's Lisa? And Bob, come here, Lisa. You've been a part of this from day one. And Bob, you know who should also be up here. So, Katie, I'm sure you're up here somewhere. And all those, yeah, everybody that was involved in this, engaged in this from the Rec and Parks. We're not going to all give you sharp instruments. I got the sharpest. Okay, but Bob, who else? That's everybody.
That's everyone.
Okay.
We should get Ed in the middle because he's got.